This guy, he made it over here all the way from the Jersey Shore. I made it seem like it was a long drive. Please welcome Mr. David Sanchez.
What is going on, everyone? Thank you, DJ, for that choice of music. I'm sure this side of the room was lost. You know what song that was? En serio? That's crazy. How did all the Latinos end up on this side of the room? Did you guys do this on purpose? I'm in a great mood. I recently lost some weight. Give it up for me. Thank you. I'm completely full of shit, but my confidence is now through the roof. Thank you, guys. I also want to thank my grandmother because all my life, my grandma used to feed me. And even though I was always fat as a kid, my grandma told me I was never fat, that I was just strong. Tú no estás gordo, tú estás fuerte, right? That's what the abuela said. This side of the room, consult with this side of the room, what I just said. Because clearly you guys are lost over here. So my girlfriend started this Facebook page, and it empowers women. And then it empowers women like, you know, you are strong, you can do anything you want. And she posted something and it really stood out to me, and I'm gonna read it for you guys today. It says, my thighs touch, my arms jiggle. I've got split ends, acne, stretch marks, big feet. My jeans don't always make it past my hips. My boobs aren't the same size. I'm absolutely flawed, and that's okay. Now, I don't know what's worse, the fact that I'm still following this page, or the fact that all that shit applied to me. Now, what I'm saying is I'm okay with my body. I know my boobs aren't the same size, and that's okay. When me and my girlfriend jump for joy, we both grab our tits. It's okay. Which leads me to this. I don't like skinny males. A skinny man can wear a V-neck out in public. I feel like I can't wear a V-neck. I feel like if I wear a V-neck out in public, I have to wear double-sided tape for fear of a nipple slip. I can't have the girls outside, you know what I'm talking about? A skinny man could go running outside, right? You're like, look at that grown-ass man, he's working out, right? If I took my shirt off, I went for a nice little jog, but look at this grown-ass man running out with his titties. That's indecent exposure, that's a charge. I'm not built for jail. My mother watches me do stand-up, and she says, how can you do it? I'm like, you made me this way. I'm fucked up because of you, right? My mother used to whoop my ass, right? And she used to fuck me up two ways, right? Every time I was doing some bullshit, my mom would be like, listen, DJ, first of all, she used to make me go get the belt she was gonna hit me with, right? After she made me grab the belt, she used to make me smell the belt. That's because my mother wanted me to know the belt she was hitting me with was 100% genuine leather. 100% genuine ass whooping, right? So one night, I'm in the room doing some bullshit, right? My mom goes, DJ, go get the belt. It's late at night, my mom's in a nightgown. I'm like, I look around, I'm like, if I don't get the belt, who's gonna get the belt? I looked at my mom, I said, you know what? No, I'm not gonna get the belt. My mom lifted up her bata and she had the belt underneath her bata. And she whooped my ass. For 3 minutes I had that belt around me. It was like a faja. It felt like a girdle for the first 3 minutes. It was hot, it was tight, sir. It was really tight, uncomfortable. That's crazy. Girls wear that, they wear like the little girdle, right? Get a little shape. You see me, I had curves, right? Actually, that belt's from Torrid. You guys know what Torrid is, right? It's a plus size store for women. That's where I got that belt. I'm a size 4 in women. I am a BBW. Nice. Before I get out of here, I want to get something off my chest. I see how this room is, you know, diversified. I don't really like white people. Let me explain. Me being a Latin comic, right? White people always feel the need to come up to me after a show and always want to tell me about a time they vacationed in Puerto Rico. I get off stage, white people be like, oh my God, you're Puerto Rican? This one time we flew into San Juan and we stopped at this little tiny restaurant and they had the best empanadas. And I felt like I would be fucked up. Like, could you imagine how this conversation would go if I went and said that to a white person? I'd be like, oh my God, you're white? This one time I was driving through Pennsylvania and we stopped at this gas station and we got Hot Pockets. I like to pretend that joke's about white people. I just really fuck with Hot Pockets. My name is David Sanchez. You guys have been awesome. Thank you.